fifth grade at Graham Elementary. We're glad you are here to watch as students from Miss Dunn's class present their Native American life inquiry projects.
Throughout our study of the Native Americans, we kept careful notes about each tribe's way of life, including their traditional style of home, the food they grew and hunted, and the environment each tribe lived in. We also made connections between each tribe's region and environment, and the way they lived their
life. As you will see, from our projects, each diorama contains our assigned tribe's home, the natural environment of that tribe, and any forest sources they may have had. We worked really hard on our project, and we hope you enjoy the presentation. Thank you for your time.
The Hopi lived in what is now the southwestern region of the United States. The Southwest includes California, Nevada, Utah, Arizona, and New Mexico. In the Southwest, it is very sandy with many hills. I made this by doing cardboard, and then I put clay around it, and then I put the sticks in the top with toothpicks, and then made that with chopsticks and toothpicks.
The Tlingit are an Indian tribe who made their homes in the northwestern region. The northwest region includes the states of Idaho, Montana, North Dakota, South Dakota, Utah, Washington, Wyoming, and Oregon. The landforms of the northwest include hills, grasslands, mountains, streams, rivers, seas, plateaus, and forests. The climate in the summer is in the 60s or 70s. The climate in the winter is chilly and often windy. The temperatures are usually in the 40s. I bought popsicle sticks for my house, and then I had to paint it, and then I went out into my yard and got a real stick so I could paint it, and then I got grass.
What is that tall stick called?
Well, it's a totem pole.
A totem pole.
They drew like faces all over the houses and totem poles for like celebrations.
The Cherokee were hunters and farmers. The women grew and the men hunted. The women grew corn, squash, beans, and the men hunted turkeys, deer, squirrels, rabbits, birds, and also fish. The weapons they hunted with were mainly of their own craft, as they included bows and arrows, blowguns, spears, and tomahawks. In addition, they used bone and stone rakes, shovels, plus other implements of that nature to farm. And back here, the guy is hunting a bear in the forest, and this is a summer house. And these people are like around an outside fire, and this is where they kept some horses.
The girls wore deerskin dresses to keep them warm. The boys wore leggings and buckskin robes. When it was really cold, they had moccasins and buffalo hide robes. The home to the Lakota Sioux is the teepee. The teepee was made out of logs, buffalo skin, and soil. For example, they built a frame of sticks, then they tied it with a long kind of leaf.
And then I have these little people. They're pollies, but I made them out of leather.
What are they wearing?
She's wearing a dress and he's wearing a shirt and pants. And then I put little moccasins on her. I used cotton balls, string, and some more leather.
The Lakota Sioux grew and hunted to get food. They farmed corn, beans, and squash. The Lakota also hunted deer, wolves, and buffalo with weapons like bows, arrows, spears, and clubs. I have a couple of people. This person is about to strike a deer with a club. And usually you won't find many trees in the plains, so there are no trees in the diorama. And this is buffalo hide. I used it as buffalo hide that they're scraping off.
The Lakota Sioux ate buffalo meat and they farmed corn and Native American squash. In addition, the animals they used the bow and arrow for hunting buffalo, rabbit, and wolf. This is squash, and that's corn.
Very cool. That's creative.
My fire. This person fell apart, but he was sitting there.
Okay.
And these people were standing up. And I made my teepee out of sticks that I got outside, leaves, and rubber bands to keep it all together.
The Lakota Sioux lives in what are now Wisconsin, Minnesota, and North and South Dakota. The region they lived in were the plains. Also, the land front of the plains would include rivers, lakes, hills, beaches, and some sand dunes. Those, like horses or something, but we couldn't find any buffalo, so we got cannonballs and we colored them brown.
Hey, that's creative.
And we glued them on, and then we have two people in the hunting them, and this is where they would dry the buffalo hide after they killed the buffalo, and then they would put it around a teepee.
We lived in the desert. Would you like to live there? It would be over 120 degrees Fahrenheit. Other than that, it was nice. All the mountains and sand dunes made it a best place to look at. Also, they lived in different. Also, the way they lived is different today. In addition, they live in the Southwest. These two farmers are having growing the farms, and the enemies are shooting up the ladder, and the defender is trying to defend their base.
Tlingit was a tribe that mostly ate seafood. Although they hunted deer, the Tlingit would rush down to the shore to catch some salmon. During the salmon run, men and women would sprint to the Pacific Ocean to get all the salmon they could. The Tlingit also found corn, beans, and squash.
I have the Iroquois tribe. I made the longhouse by folding paper, same thing I did with the bush a little and the tree. Just keeps falling a little. I made the people by cutting out a person shape and then coloring to make it kind of look realistic. I have some corn right here, but
we did this project to show how the Indians lived, also what they did, because in that in the heart. Later, the days and the early years were really hard for other people.